Hai, saya Chef Zamri, pemilik restoran Songket. Hari ini saya nak tunjukkan di dalam restoran Songket macam mana. Jom mari ikut saya.
Alangkah indah berseri bertambah cantik. Alangkah indah berseri bertambah cantik. Kainlah Songket tenun Melayu. Mula asalnya dari Terengganu.
Hari pertama kami beroperasi pada 15 Mac tahun 2011. Daripada cetusan idea untuk melahirkan satu restoran authentic Malay cuisine, restoran tradisional yang mengeluarkan makanan-makanan yang tradisi Melayu kita, tapi kita persembahkan dengan keadaan yang modern. That's why kita dapat sambutan daripada pihak endorse daripada pihak Tourism Malaysia, travel agency dan hotel-hotel, dan kita punya target market pun daripada orang-orang asing, pelancong yang datang ke Malaysia. Pada awalnya saya dengan rakan partner saya nak namakan batik restoran. Tapi bila memandangkan kita buat comparison dengan perbandingan antara batik dan songket, saya nak menampakkan lebih eksklusif, lebih high end, so saya pilih songket. Bila kita sudah tetapkan, okey, kita daripada pelabur ni kita dah tetapkan, okey, kita akan buat restoran berkonsepkan Melayu. Apa pula yang kita akan buat lain daripada yang lain untuk attract the people datang ke Songket Restaurant? Pasal masakan Melayu semua orang tahu, tapi untuk European people yang market luar, dia nak something special. So saya fikir kita olah makanan-makanan Melayu kita dengan persembahan yang agak moden. Sebenarnya di Songket Restaurant, menu-menu dia kesemuanya menu masakan tradisional Melayu. Konsep kita yang kita pamerkan kat sini, makanan kita berkonsepkan makan berhidang. Okay, kita tak ada makan untuk individual. Kebanyakannya untuk makan untuk sharing satu keluarga. Terus kalau dengar pun biasa saja pada orang kita. Okey, macam masak lemak ayam langka, asam pedas, daging dendeng, okey. Itu sebenarnya yang istimewanya pada mereka, yang pada pelancong-pelancong ni, dia nak mencuba. Dan tugas kami pula pramu saji di sini macam mana mempromosi makanan tu kepada mereka. Itu salah satu taktik kita untuk attract dia untuk mencuba. Dan mereka tak tahu semua jenis makanan ni. Kalau dia orang baca sendiri pun dia orang tak tahu. So kita, tugas kita di sini terangkan kepada mereka apa benda setiap food ini. Sekarang ini dah nak masuk tahun ketiga. Ada dua perancangan terkini. Satunya kami akan lebih fokus kepada event perkahwinan yang agak eksklusif. Pada masa sekarang ni, saya masih bukan lagi 100% on pemilik restoran. Saya masih ada partner, saya masih ada pihak pelabur. Saya menggunakan pelabur-pelabur ini untuk melabur di restoran ini. Okay. Saya tak bergerak seorang. Dalam perjalanan perniagaan ni, saya tak bergerak seorang. Saya ada tim, saya ada kawan karib saya. Saya ada orang di belakang saya yang bagi nasihat. Okey. Kalau nak kata seorang diri, saya rasa agak mustahil. Tak ada, jarang orang bergerak berjaya dapat berdiri atas kaki sini. Pada pelanggan, saya harap pelanggan-pelanggan saya yang sedia ada dan yang belum pernah datang, saya harap untuk cuba datang ke Songket Restaurant. Bukan sahaja mencuba kita punya makanan, cuba rasa kita punya environment di sini. Yang sudah ada, sudah pernah datang, harap still lagi support kita, Songket Restaurant, untuk lebih orang kenal, sampaikan kepada kawan-kawan.
Sudah dekat di meja, combination of the turmeric with the sugar.
Now in the kitchen of the Songket Restaurant, Chef Zumbi, right? And I'm just dying to find out what he's going to prepare for us today, right? So Chef Zarmi, what will you be preparing for us today?
Right, today we will prepare the one of the menu from the Songket Restaurant. I am rempah bertumis. So this all the ingredients.
Check out the ingredients, guys.
All right, guys, he's gonna start now.
Right.
First, the chicken is to be fried. He makes sure that the oil is at the desired range of temperatures before inserting the chicken. Make sure to fry the chicken till it's half cooked. That looks about right. As you can see, the chef is kind enough to make me his sous chef. And now, we are preparing to make the gravy. Throw in the onion, the garlic, and the curry leaves and sauté them well. This dish is based from India and has been modified into the Malay taste. Add some water and curry mix and keep on stirring. Now add the chicken to the gravy and stir them well. The chef mentions that this dish is usually eaten as tidbits or it can be eaten with bread. Interesting, huh? Then add some chili powder and lastly, coconut milk. Keep cooking until it's fairly dry. Chilies are added for garnishing purposes. Spread some cashew nuts as the finishing touch and phew! Can't wait, guys. I can't wait.
Sungguh indah bunga kemboja. Di bawah atap di tepi halaman. Juara sudah diletak di meja. Sudilah santap Tuan Budiman. So guys, without further ado.
I'll be having the otak-otak to start things off. The otak-otak is a traditional steamed seafood mousse with karut leaf and wrapped in banana leaf. Taste the freshness of the fish and the shrimp in every bite.
I really like the combination of the turmeric with the shrimp inside and the fish taste.
Moving on to the pucuk paku goreng. It is a wild fern shoot stir-fried with chili, shallot, and garlic with shrimps on top. It's good. Let's see how it tastes with rice. Yes, it is definitely better with rice. Oh, just for my next victim, the ikan patin masak tempoyak. It's patin fish simmered in fresh turmeric and special fermented durian. What a very strong tempoyak smell. So excited. The first bite is definitely a memorable experience. There's nothing like it. So I'm gonna have some more of this. So next on my list, the ayam rempah bertumis, which I helped the chef made earlier. It is fried chicken in special homemade spiced gravy and herbs with some garnishing on top. Need I explain more after my hand gesture? It is delicious, period. I'm now having it alone with rice. So good. To cool things off, I'm gonna have a sip of this babe. It's the kandondong asam boy. It is not your usual beverage as it contains huge chunks of kandondong pulp. I'm loving it. Simply refreshing. I continue with the chicken again, only this time I'm having it without rice. So good. Let's move on to dessert, shall we? It is somewhat adorable in appearance and I'm excited for my first taste. This is called tepung bungkus ala Songket. Basically, it is Songket-style traditional homemade Malay kuih with creamy coconut milk, filled with sweet cascaded coconut. What a sweetheart, and rich in taste. Lastly, I'm gonna have the fresh orange juice. Well, you can never go wrong with fresh orange juice, am I right, guys? If you want a more indulging dining experience, this restaurant has a cultural performance at night, which is the perfect blend with the concept of Songket. Wouldn't want to miss the fun too. Ah, looks like I've been called up onto the stage by one of these lovely, lovely dancers. Let's see if I have some hidden talent in me, shall we? Well, okay, maybe dancing is not one of my strongest suits, but I definitely had fun.
That was so much fun, guys. What an experience I had at the Songket restaurant. I mean, I'm feeling very Malaysian right now. So with that said, until next time, same place, only on West Coast.
Lagi tak ada tune.